speaking with one of our charter members, gave me a little information I didn't have. This church began in 1961. The second month of its existence, bought a piece of property in a house for $17,000. 17 acres in a house for $17,000. Can you imagine? But in 1961, $17,000 was a lot of money. From that day to 30th day of September of this year, this church has been in debt. 48 years. Done a lot of building, done a lot of things. But that's a long time. God is good. I was maybe reminiscing in my mind about some things. I long felt early on in the ministry, probably the very first week, that I've been over my head. And I've never quite gotten out of the water, barely enough to breathe. I've always been over my head. I've always been of the Lord placed in places that I couldn't do it, so that He could show me that He could. I remember coming here 17 years ago, and I have never been so overwhelmed in all of my life. I have never known a time when I felt so completely unable to do anything. Those of you who hark back to those days, every day was a crisis. It literally was, every single day. And to look at what God has done, never dawned on me. I could not have conceived of this church moving. That nothing could have been further from my mind when I came here. And that God has moved us out here, that God has progressively met every need. I was telling someone earlier, the payments we were making back then, we could not make today. We just couldn't do it. Some of you remember back that far, the payments were $17,228 a month, 71 cents. I don't think I'll ever forget that. I don't know how it happened. But God was so good. He brought us here, He put us here, He sustained us here, and to this good day, God paid the bill.
Amen.
That was the Lord.
Yeah.
Look at the little handout. A year and a half ago, we still owed $300,000. And I'm sure other people were praying. I was begging God, please, somehow, there has to be a way to get out from under this. And God brought us the money from someone none of us know. Or you, she's dead. We were part of an estate of a lady no one had ever heard of. No one knows anything about her. But God brought the money.
Yeah.
And then in May, this church undertook a plan to eliminate this thing by Thanksgiving. And with great thanksgiving, we give God the glory. He did it. I've been privileged to burn notes, mortgages, and churches I pastor, it's always a great delight. None is so delightful as this. This is, of course, not the original mortgage, by the way, it's not even the original or the one we're learning. You keep those in a file. I've already been asked, are you going to burn the real thing? I'm going to keep that in case the bank forgets that you're paying. This mortgage, even since we moved out here, has been moved four times. Because we were always looking for a way to save money and lower the interest rate. And the Lord was so gracious. We were paying 5.95% on this loan when we finally completed it, which is still phenomenal, even with this day of lower rates. So God has done the work, hasn't He?
Amen.
Give Him the glory. I would like to ask a charter member to come and help me. I think it's appropriate that a charter member help me with this. So Don Subject, you come up here. He's going to be my receiver. And he's going to catch the fire. I tested this paper. It does burn. Well, if I can handle this thing, of course, you got a burn hole.
Didn't test the lighter.